Hey everyone, welcome to episode 6 of Sanitarium. Believe it or not, this is my second time going through this, and the first time we actually got pretty far, but by the grace of God, I actually saved between each session, so now we can start back where we left off at. In the last episode, we were able to get Gino to go and get a tattoo for Inferno at the tattoo artist, and we were able to take that needle, which we need. Also, there was something that I was supposed to get. There was an oil can over there where that family was, where that crazy woman was at. I got the oil can, and I needed more tickets for the places that we're about to go now, and I already got that taken care of. So we're going to try to go through this fairly quickly, because that first session was perfect. But now, I'm doing it again, and I'm not happy about it. So, let's get started. So now we got to go down to the beach, and there's a freak show down here, and we need to go and speak to the freak shows. But first, we need to go and talk to some of these this clown right here before we start going in to see the freaks.
That clown scares me. My name's Sarah. What's yours?
I'm Zippy, master of the art of fortune-telling. My cards contain the hidden secrets of the cosmos.
Ooh, can you tell me my fortune?
Certainly. Let me consult the cards. Ah, yes. This is very interesting indeed.
Ooh, what do they say?
A bleeding heart. You will soon witness a frightening ritual of gore and dismemberment. A savage people will rain blood down upon you. Ha ha ha!
That's awful. Are you sure you're reading the cards right?
Well, no. This is just the Ace of Hearts. I think I grabbed the wrong deck of cards this morning.
That's one crazy clown, I tell you the truth. Alright, so, the first freaks we're going to meet is the twins.
Ew, they're connected. My name's Sarah. What's yours?
My name's Matt. And my sister's name is Ashley.
You're connected!
That's what Siamese twins are, Sarah.
Well, thank you. Oh gosh, she is so stuck up, I never did like Ashley. Anyway, we gotta talk to this guy, and I think we needed like 5 tickets to get through.
He looks like Mr. Potato Head. Put together wrong.
I know, right? And I believe we have enough. We got 10 tickets.
My name's Sarah. What's yours?
Stuart Limkin, my good child. A purveyor of earthly oddities, if you will. A peddler of the perverted beasts that lurk in the shadows of your mind. I am a collector of freaks, and I humbly welcome you to my monument of monstrosities.
Where do the freaks come from?
Does it really matter, child? They have been assembled here for your entertainment, kept safely behind iron bars so you can observe at your leisure.
I always wanted to go to a freak show, but I don't like calling it a freak show, but I always wanted to go to an attraction like that. Seems kind of cool.
How many tickets to get in?
A mere 5 tickets. Half of 10, and one less than half a dozen. A small price to pay to see what few will encounter in the space of a lifetime.
I've heard that one of your freaks got loose during the flood, and now he's eating everyone who goes in the water.
The forces of Mother Nature are not mine to wield, my girl. During the Great Calamity, Iggy took the opportunity to free himself from the shackles of man and returned once more to his watery domain. Who am I to judge this misunderstood creature?
Maybe because he looks misunderstood. Look, a hot mess, lumpy head, but anyway. Okay, so now that we know what the dealio is and how to get in, let's go ahead and grab our tickets.
Thank you. Now, step lively, little girl, for the gallery of the grotesque awaits.
Appreciate it. His legs look like they were made out of wood too, or maybe I'm looking. Oh, that's a cane he's holding. Oh, okay. Okay, that's confirmed, because I never could figure that out when I was playing the game. So we got 2 freaks we need to meet. One looks like Dalsim from Street Fighter, but of course Dalsim is better.
He's all bendy. My name's Sarah. What's yours?
I am Pretzul, the master of elasticity.
Ooh. Can you light up a light bulb?
What? No, no, not electricity. Elasticity.
What does that word mean, mister?
That means I can twist and stretch myself into many different shapes.
He's like, what? No, I didn't say electricity, baby girl. I said elasticity. Whatever he said.
How long have you been a freak in the circus?
For many years now. I've seen quite a few freaks come and go. But that squid boy was the worst of the lot.
Okay, we're back. I'm sorry about that. Had a little bit of a interruption. All right, so we talked to Pretzel. And we got one more to meet. And this is Timber. He's a wolfman dog. Werewolf, whatever you want to call it.
I can't tell if he's a man or a big dog.
I wish he'd stop running around that cage and talk to us.
My name's Sarah. What's yours?
Timber. Go away, kid, before I eat you.
What a terrible thing to say. I was just being friendly.
If you want to be friendly, release me from this damn cage.
If I let you out, you'll eat me. You said so yourself.
Promise. I promise not to. If you let me out.
How could I trust you? You look like you'd eat the first thing you get your hands on.
No, not you. I smell bones. Sweet scent of marrow. Driving me mad. I'm starving. I want out. Will you lead me to the bones?
Ooh, you sound crazy as I don't know what.
You can smell bones? Where are they? I haven't seen any on this entire island.
Buried. Deep. Underground. I can smell them. I can. I'll dig them up.
Gee, I don't know.
Please, kid. I'm dying in this wretched cage. I need out.
Why doesn't Stuart just open your cage? Doesn't he have a key?
Key lost. Damn, Stuart lost it. Need to pick it open now.
Okay, so that was why we needed that needle that we got from the tattoo artist, so we can pick Timber out. First of all, I gotta get her position right, because she'll be like, oh, I can't do that.
I can't do that.
See?
Should I? I don't.
I don't. Well, she did it now, girl.
That's it. Oh, free. Thank you. Bones. Dig them up.
Ow.
Well, so Timber's free, and we needed to free him, actually. That was something that we needed to do. So now that we got Timber situated, that oil can I mentioned, I needed that for this lever, for this merry-go-round, because we're trying to get to that fun house you all kept seeing, that one of you all mentioned.
An oil.
There we go. And without this oil can, she wouldn't be able to work this lever. So now, we can get it going, and we can get on this merry-go-round.
It looks fun, but the animals scare me. Whee! Uh-oh. Oh, poo.
I know, right? Because it's just whacking toe up. But that allows us to have access to that fun house. And we needed 5 tickets, because it takes 5 tickets to get into this blasted funhouse, and I had 10, so we got 5. We're perfect.
Step on up to the sign, twerp. Spanky will say if you goes in or not. Ha ha! Throw this one back in the water, Spanky. She's too small.
So, if we went and talked to the guy, he'll tell us that, oh, well, you can't get in. You got to be a certain height to get in. You need 5 tickets to get in. Well, we already got that. But what's missing, if you notice during that cutscene, that Spanky here doesn't have a nose, which is why we have that red ball that juggler gave us, and this is exactly what we need in order to get into the funhouse.
Okay, Shrimpo, step up to the sign and Spanky will... What the... I guess you're okay, Stretch.
Thank you.
Aw, how sweet was Spanky. He was so nice. So let's not even talk to this guy, because he's going to be wasting our time anyway. And give him our last 5 tickets.
Thanks, Squirt. The House of Horror awaits.
And this little girl got a name, fool. Anyway, we'll walk up in here and go through this long waiting line blockage. What is those things called? I don't know. But anyway, we'll go in there and see what awaits in this funhouse. So that was a nice little cutscene, and that mirror was the last thing we needed to get off this island. Now, I would talk to this dude with the big old mouth, but he really has nothing interesting to say, as nothing really pertains to the storyline. All he does is tells us that he's drunk, and he's scared that he's gonna get eaten up, basically. So we're not even gonna just waste our time with him, talking with that big megaphone mouth thing, or whatever the case may be. But the woman that's in this thing is a fortune teller in this tent, and she's very important. So watch and see what happens.
Ooh, she has a crystal ball. Hello, my name is...
Sarah.
Wow, you knew!
Of course I did. I'm quite skilled in the mystic arts, my child. My name is Lady of Honor.
Lady of Honor got some parabola.
Would you tell me my future?
Normally I would charge you. But with the way things are, I see no point in it. Come closer. I will need to see your Paul.
I see that you are far from home, and that you are not who you appear to be. You possess the solution to an important problem, although outside forces conspire against you. How unusual. Your hands tell the stories of someone easily 3 times your age. Well, I must rest now, but I will give you one final piece of advice. On your way home, beware the pit of darkness. You can only pass through safely when you've sought out the wand, flask, and reflection.
I feel all sick.
And as you can see, she was the one that was the real fortune teller. If we just asked her about Zippy, she would have dissed Zippy and like, oh, he's not a fortune teller, he's a fake. But now that she zapped us back here, the things that she mentioned was the flask, the wand, and the reflection thing. That was the mirror and the wand that we used to fire breathe. And the alcohol that we use to help us fire breathe, to give us that fuel. And we have all 3 of those things. So, it would be confusing though, if you were the first time playing this and you didn't know that, you'd be like, okay, what is she talking about? But they give you a little bit of clues of what's what. So we have to actually go back to where that family is, because there is a hole, excuse me sir, there's a hole that has opened up there. And one of you asked what this thing was over here in the left corner. It's a clown. I talked to him, but he's not important either. He's just a guy that has a stank attitude. And he cusses a lot. And the little girl says he cusses a lot. Alright, so it's time to get off of this island. Let's go in here.
Timber! 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 Did you find your bone?
Found them. But something smells bad.
What is it? What's wrong?
Rotten, like death. Must leave. Have to climb out.
Timber!
Well, we have to face Iggy. It was coming, and now we have to face Iggy. All right, so the lady mentioned the piece of reflection, which is the mirror. You can't really see, but there's a little thing here that looks like a little campfire pit. We need to put that mirror on
that.
We need to put the mirror on that.
Huh? They're burning.
And it lights. And with that, we use our wand and stuff to light it. All right, so now we're ready to fire breathe, because that is the one way to defeat Iggy.
That squid monster's in here somewhere.
Now if you hear, first of all, this is a brave little girl, but if you hear her heartbeat, can you hear it? That tells you your life, like how much life you got. So the faster it beats, the more you're about ready to die, but you have to be careful. Did you hear that? You have to be careful, because stalactites, I think they're stalactites, they fall. And they can't hit you. Okay, all right. That would have gone well if I'd have clicked on that, but you, whoa. Oh, we gotta be careful. Usually this takes about, this usually takes about two or three times for me to do this, but I'm gonna see if I can get it in the first go. In the first session, I did it. I aced it on the first go. But let's see if I can do it. All right, all right. And it's hard to see. There's a path that goes up. And we stayed up, because if you'd gone here, you'd have been trapped down here. But we stayed up and we did it. So now here's Iggy. We gotta blow the fire into his eye. One more time. One more time. Oh, I died. That's okay. That's all right. It doesn't reset, which is great. So that means we got one more hit to go. If we hadn't got hit by those stalactites, and then we hadn't got hit by, what am I trying to say? His one tentacle that one time, we'd have got it. Okay. So the stalactites do reset. Whoa. Okay, I gotta be careful. So luckily, the stalactites make a sound. There you go, to let you know when they're about to fall. So just, oh, that was close. That was tricky. Okay, so one more hit towards old Iggy, and we got it. He dead.
See you in hell, freak.
Oh, go ahead on, girl. Ha ha. So we kill Iggy. All right. You guys remember that house that we saw at the beginning when we first entered into the circus on the island? This is where we are. It's a mansion. And this mansion has a lot of stories to it. And we'll find that out. Hopefully. I'm gonna have to check the time. We might have to do this in the next episode. So give me just a second. Let me check first. Yep, we are out of time, you guys. You have to wait until the next episode so we can go through this house. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Thank you so much for being so patient and being so supportive of this series. I will see you in the next episode of Sanitarium.